Let's start off by editing what the person looks like. Double click and draw him from the above view. Now, I'm just going to draw it very quickly because, well, you don't really want to watch me drawing a person in great detail. There. In game, you'll see that he looks like that, but when he changes direction, he doesn't change direction. To fix this, we'll need to draw the other directions. Now, there are two ways you can do this. You can draw each direction separately, or you right-click on the one you've already made and choose Create Rotated Directions, and it does it all automatically for you. Click OK, play the game, but oh no! He's teleporting when he changes direction. Now, this is due to where the hotspot is on his character. Click on the Hotspot tool and click on the middle of his body. This is the point around which he'll rotate, so it's important to be in the middle of his body. Apply to all directions, play it again, and look, he no longer teleports. However, when he fires bullets, you'll find that it doesn't always fire out from where he is. This is because bullets are fired out from the action spot, which is a bit like the hotspot, only it determines where bullets are fired out of. So click on the action point and put it where you want the bullet to be. Apply to other directions. Okay, but there's one last thing we need to do. We now need to go into the bullet and make sure that the hotspot and action spot, just to be safe, are in the middle of the bullet. Now it should fire out from the front of him, no matter which direction he looks. Yay! Now, animations in the Games Factory 2 are done in several different ways. If you've got a pre-built movement type for your character, as mentioned in part 1, it'll have built-in animations for all the different actions. For example, if you've got a platform character, he'll have different animation types. He'll use the walking one, the jumping one, the falling one, and possibly the climbing one. Now, if you want him to climb when he goes up a ladder, you need to do a climbing animation in this bit here. If not, it'll just simply remain on whichever one you have drawn. As you get better with the Games Factory 2, you'll probably want to make your own animations. To do this, scroll down to the bottom of the list, right-click, and choose New. You have complete control over these animations that you make. You can choose when these are played, if they're played, and everything about them, really. But for now, I'm just going to keep this as simple as possible and show you how to animate. Go to the stopped animation. It currently has one frame of animation. If we play it, it looks like this. Say you want him to blink. We'll need more than one frame of animation. You can right-click on this and click Clone Frame. This will make another one. Let's do this a couple of times. There, we now have four frames. If we want him to blink, we choose one of these frames and we make it look like he's got his eyes closed. He'll now blink. However, it doesn't loop. To make it loop, go to the direction options and choose Loop. This will now loop. Yay! That is our animation. We can apply it to other directions by right-clicking on the one we've already done and by creating rotated directions. You can now see that he blinks in-game. I mean, it's a stupid example, but now you see how animation works and you can do your own ones in your own time. Maybe he could be breathing in and out or something like that. You'll now see me drawing things in more detail, sped up obviously, so it's not boring. And then at the end, I'll talk about automatic rotations, which is a faster way of doing different rotations on a character, but possibly less logical than the way you already know. There is an option in the Games Factory 2 called Automatic Rotations. What this allows you to do is to only draw one direction and it creates the other directions from that. To enable it, select the object that you'd like to have automatic rotations, go to the Runtime Options tab, and scroll down to the bottom. You'll see Automatic Rotations there. Tick it, and all you'll need is just one direction here. So I'll just delete the other ones now. Okay, and when you play the game, you'll see that they still constantly look in the direction they're running. This helps to save memory and time, really, but it only works in certain games. You're not going to be able to do it in a side view shooter, because if they run the other way, they'll suddenly start running upside down. But it's a useful little thing to know, and it can be applied to any of the objects that you see here. Have fun!